Packers. Another very off the cuff video with something that I've just bloody discovered just now. I've been down to the manufacturers this morning to get the templates drawn up for the workstation. I gave mine to Gary Rowell when it turns out I needed that on Jeff's job. So I've just got one of the old ones out now just to show you what, roughly what that idea, but to talk about this. While I was down there, I got him to knock up a quick prototype sort of thing of what I wanted to make a clamp out of for the gun tracks with the other clamps that I'm making. But I brought it home and used it quickly, and it is spot on. But I was just thinking it can do the best for both worlds. You can use it on the Romus as well as a new Gundulax. And seeing as it's such a, you know, a remote thing you're ever going to use, I don't think I'm going to bother making it into a solid clamp. They'll be able to work on the old clamps or anything, any clamp you've got on the guillotine. And on the Romus, you've got to just find your own way to secure this back there. And I've done this to Gary's at the moment, it's driving me mad. I've just secured an 18 inch bar there and I'm just going to work all my cuts off of that. But I'll do a little demo thing. I'm just going to, like, just going to be fair to the Romus lads as well. I can show it working on both, but yeah, I'll show you on the Romus first quickly. Oh, but I was figuring I can get these templates like knocked out, couldn't I? For that, they're only if you want to do that design, but yeah, look, basically on the gun drag and that, like, it's going to be easier to move the clamps that I've got made coming. I'm just going to do the straight and the 45 because that's this is just going to be like every now and then. But obviously on them you're going to have the clamp, you're going to clamp this in, it's going to be square up here. We haven't got that with the Romus, so I'm just going to, you know, set some tiles in. If we want, we're going to be doing 6-inch cubes, so I'll set it up like that. So after that, all you're going to be doing, I mean, the Romus boys, you're going to glue this, aren't you? I mean, in all honesty, if you're going to be running off load, even the Gundulac boys, you're going to need to glue it too. But what it'll do, whatever size cube you want, really, I mean, it's catered for up to the 9s maybe. You're going to be able to run your cubes off, you know, providing you've got that. So what I'm going to do is I've asked the manufacturers to give us a price on just knocking these out in a 5mm and do that instead of making them out of the metal. But the fun bit I just want to, like, show you I'll do on the gun to that, because it is the better guillotine. So right, so I'm just going to run a load off. So the old fast forward thing will come on now. And obviously my new clamps will be coming soon, so you haven't got to worry about that. So I will as well. I'm going to be cutting down a few 18s first, so that itself can be setting, you know, just the shear, because it's a long one. Just the shear a bit more. I'm just going to put that down because it's obviously a much longer tile. That's better. So I'm going to get those cuts I want. Obviously how you do this is up to you. This is just what I'm doing to, this wouldn't even be how I'd do it. I'd have one stuck on the back there like you've seen me do many times before, but this is not about the actual guillotine. This is just a fun thing I found with the pattern. Right, see, I even saw that little clamp try to move then. They're such, my one, when it comes, it's going to be that wide. It's going to have 3 nuts on it and it's going to really hold it. But like I said, I can show you the template to make these yourself, but I'm going to get them actually machine, because the difference between this little beauty and the one that I made myself, you know, you can just tell the difference. It's just that gnat's cock left or right that gives you that accuracy, and you're only going to get that really from the machines. So let's see what we're going to do. Then. Run your first edge in. This I thought was just going to be for the cube design and things like that lot, but as everything we keep doing, it is turned into something else. Well, we're going to see in a minute. Pause this one and I'll do it all and get more cut. I've done, you know, I'll split my planks down to 18. Now I'll put this one here, another plank in here, which ideally I would stick, but again, I've left my tape with Jeff. So, but now what I've got to split that plank in half, it gives me 2E18. It's going to help me keep the waist down to get as maximum as I can out of a plank. So if that's a plank dead split, you know, I can either shank for the back or recut the edge there. You know, the other thing I could suggest, if you're doing absolutely boatloads of them, you know, just a bit of tape behind, something like that, to give you more things to check it on. And spin it around. Sometimes with custom works, you do have to rework your own work sometimes. We've done that. Right, to check them now, so that's why I put the plank in there, to get a long one across. If I push that up to there, by rights, if I push that there, it's got to be the same, isn't it? So, that's how you check your tiles as you're cutting. There's no point, you just can't check one edge if it's not good the other edge, you know? So, another one on this one. And if you're running loads off, set a number to start, have a little checking point, like 10 or 15 of them every now and then, put them into a jig, check they're all right. And the reason you do that, because if you're running off hundreds of them and all of a sudden you just check one and it's wrong, you've then got to go back, you know, over fucking all of them to make sure they're all right. But it's if you check one every 20 or 15, if your jig's moved and one ain't fitting right, the maximum you're going to have to go back and check is just your last, you know what I mean, last 10, 15. So. And that just out of the half plank, and that's it. I mean, we're getting Nixie's waist, but I'll show you what to do with the waist bits in a minute if you want some fun. I like working Imperial, it's so much easier. Everything turns around and fits everything else, and there's no hassle. See, if I were to cut them all down exactly in half, then I'm gonna have all these as equal segments, and I, you know. So if you set a jig for that first, and then you could do things with, you know, these leftovers, you can just
bring forth the guillotine. Bring forth the guillotine. Bring forth the guillotine! Bring forth the guillotine! Bring forth the guillotine!
Terrifying ordeal inside the outer limits of the lab. Or would you like to see the survival? the world's return and serve suffering. You can now sit back and wipe the cold sweat from your brow. Your blood pressure has returned to normal. Stay tuned and patient for the next episode of the Triple Element in the Outer Zones.